My name is Amlesh Otar. I'm from Malpin Globe Consulting. We're a business advisory and project transaction advisory firm. We focus in the energy, the engineering, as well as the manufacturing sectors. We've had the pleasure of working on projects in Southern Africa as well as on the west of Africa. There's definitely a shift in the market space when it comes to clients considering actually generating power on their own, generating energy ultimately, and using it as a natural gas in their solution allows them to then play around with the different types of arrangements. You've got your typical gas to power. You can also use the waste heat that's generated from the technologies to supply your thermal needs. And there you have CHP, which is combined heating and power, or CCHP, combined cooling, heating and power. Ultimately, this allows the manufacturing plants to utilize their different solutions, because ultimately it becomes essentially an efficiency solution, and that ensures that you have the most viable and the most feasible, that is, project solution. So the main reason for using natural gas as a fuel source is it is a cleaner fuel source. It emits 50% less CO2 than coal, and it does give you some options in terms of the way it's actually supplied to your project. And therefore you have a pipe gas, which is the more preferred option. It does provide a cheaper option for fuel supply. Then there are the options that a client could obviously look at as a backup in terms of CNG as well as LNG. We've seen some clients that actually have utilized quad generation, whereby they've taken your fuel source, combusted it, generated your power. The waste heat is then, you have two options. You can use it for thermal, or you could actually take a portion of that, put it through essentially an absorption chiller, generate your cooling, and thereafter your flue gas, which is rich in CO2, there's then the option of extracting CO2. We see property developers now integrating an energy solution into their development. So it's definitely gone across the board. And I think with regard to the way that NERSA and DOE have now positioned it, it does open up the doors a bit more. And we're seeing more of the small to medium-sized clients actually coming on board, looking at how do we optimize our energy supply, how do we optimize our energy demand, and then trying to find a solution that fits them. And typically, it's more of a baseload type solution, hence why natural gas seems to be the best fit. Feasibility perspective to a client, having pipe gas to your site, it all comes down to the bottom line. You end up with a cheaper supply of fuel. Granted, there is a larger capex fee in terms of getting the pipeline there, but once it's installed, you then have that flexibility on the pricing, and the more you use, the cheaper it gets.